This month marks 78 years since the first successful detonation of an atom bomb. It was known as the Trinity Test. And a new documentary tells the story behind the lead scientist who built that bomb, J. Robert Oppenheimer. The doc is titled To End All War, Oppenheimer and the Atomic Bomb. It's produced by NBC News Studios, and the film premieres Sunday at 10 p.m. Eastern, right here on MSNBC. Here's a look.
We interrupt this program with a special bulletin. President Roosevelt is dead. The president died of a cerebral hemorrhage.
April 1945 was one of those months in which the fate of the world seemed to turn on a dime.
FDR dies, followed by Hitler committing suicide.
Hitler's empire burns and shrivels.
The bomb is conceived in a kind of anti-Hitler fervor. By the spring of 1945, Hitler's out of the picture. The Nazis are no longer a threat. Hitler's not going to build an atomic bomb and drop it on New York. That's not going to happen. But there was no way they were not going to finish that weapon.
They wanted to make this happen. They didn't want the war to end before it happened. Oppenheimer wanted the bomb to be used, because how else would the world know what it was?
Harry S. Truman was sworn in as president of the United States.
By the time Truman gets to the presidency, the wheels are in motion. This bomb is going to be dropped somewhere. With the death of Hitler, the target then becomes Japan.
Joining us now, the film's executive producer and director, Chris Cassel, and Pulitzer Prize-winning historian and journalist, Kai Bird. He is co-author of the book, American Prometheus, The Triumph and Tragedy of J. Robert Oppenheimer, which inspired the upcoming film, Oppenheimer, directed by Christopher Nolan. Good morning to you both. Kai, I want to start with you. I had a chance preview to see the film, the Oppenheimer film, the Christopher Nolan movie. I saw it in IMAX. It just blew me out the back of the theater, the movie inspired by your book. And this new NBC News doc is just for students of 20th century history. You just gobble it up. It's so well done and so good. So if you can just a little bit paint for our viewers a picture of the circumstances as we just saw Hitler has died. Now the focus is on Japan and ending that war and how things really went into warp speed to get this bomb built.
Oh, absolutely. And Oppenheimer is at the center of this whole story. And we come back to him repeatedly because he's the father of the atomic bomb, and he's given us the dawn of the atomic age, and we're still living with that weapon and trying to figure out how to live with it. And of course, he was determined to make sure that the world understood during World War II what had been created. And one of his arguments was that this weapon needed to be understood as something so large that it would make all war impossible in the future, that it was such a terrible weapon.
Chris, as you set out to end all war, this extraordinary documentary film coming to MSNBC this weekend, what surprised you? I think a lot of us have a knowledge of who Robert Oppenheimer is, of course, and a little bit about the story behind the race to build the bomb and to end World War II. But what about the story did you find you didn't know, you didn't realize?
Yeah, well, I think one thing that was interesting that's kind of an aside that we talk about at the end was the fact that he essentially discovered black holes before they were actually discovered, which is something that's not often talked about in terms of, you know, looking back at his resume. But the same day that Germany invaded Poland in 1939, he published a paper basically predicting that black holes could exist. And then, of course, they weren't discovered until 1971 after he died. And so it's always been said that, you know, had they been discovered when he was alive, that he may have won a Nobel Prize for that work, which is something that eluded him his entire life. So that was, you know, that was a really interesting little bit.